Well, I thought I'd just give you a bit of a general workshop update. The ECHO mower, I was talking to my neighbour the other day, who's a bit of a two-stroke nut. He really knows this stuff, and he reckoned that the reason this wasn't running too well was because of an air leak. Well, that's what I thought, but I thought it was at the crankcase because it's split. Well, I think it's still partly leaking there, and that's not helping. But he reckoned that it was leaking, or it would be more likely to be leaking from there. And indeed it was, so I took that off, cleaned up the joining faces, put some sealant there, and that has helped a lot. I've got a bit more control on the mixture needle now, so that's good. Oh, and just quickly for anyone who is wondering how you set the mixture on one of these, because there's no screw visible. You take that throttle body out like that. Well, it's a butterfly really, but it's barrel shaped. That's your needle there. That bit controls your mixture. You loosen that screw, raise it to make it richer, lower it to make it leaner. Most of them are set far too rich and need to be leaned right out. Anything I'll say is when you do eventually get that to thread back on. Let me swap hands. Sorry. It's difficult to do reasonable camera work and do this. But anyway, make sure that's tight. Anyway, it is a really nice little mower, this one. I love using it. It's great fun. Probably wants the blade sharpening, and the engine really wants a little rebuild, but it works fine for the moment. And you might see this around a few rallies this year, or next year rather. Take it round the ring, bit of fun. Obviously had the Bamford out today, it's running all right now. Mr. D-Gen set, that ran, well, I mean on Saturday at Kingsfold that ran 13 hours straight. Friday, I did run it for a bit in the evening, probably about 6 hours. And on the Sunday it did about 8 hours, so I had a good long run, bit of a workout. Worsley, well, it's still running okay, and I think I'm going to pair that with one of the dynamos quite soon on a new trolley, but that'll be next year. Ruston, that hasn't been out since Kew Bridge, but it ran very nicely there, got a lot of nice comments, so I was pleased about that. But rather sadly, a couple of weeks ago now, my granddad passed away. He'd been very ill, so yeah, I think it kind of means his suffering's over. That's the way I look at it. But still very sad. But anyway, we're clearing out all his stuff at the moment, and they said I can have some of his old tools and things. So that's his pillar drill to replace mine, which stopped working a while back. And it goes quite nicely. Guard on there. Various different speed pulleys. Quite a nice throw as well. Got my milling slide on there too. Or drilling slide, whatever. Also got quite a few drill bits. A tin of drill bits there. And another little vise which I'll mount on the workbench there eventually. I've got a little router. I've just been trying that out. But another better miter saw, power drill, saws, chisels, whole box of stuff. Brand new chisels. They're really nice. But yeah, I was very pleased to be allowed to have that stuff. And for me, it's kind of nice, a nice way to be able to remember him by, because he was an electrical engineer most of his life, radar, even worked in the war in a factory making the mosquito fighter. You know, so to be able to have this stuff is quite special for me. Lathe that got used recently. I've tightened the belt up. There are a bit of a Heath Robinson method, I won't go into that too much, but it worked. Did those washes for the Manco trolley. On the subject of the Manco, lots of people have been asking me, when are you going to do another update, or how's it going? I don't mind you asking, that's fine. But basically not a lot's happened with it at the moment. I've painted the cylinder head, built the trolley obviously, but I haven't gone much further than that. Hopefully this Saturday I'll be getting those flywheels stripped maybe. But I'll also try and get the trolley varnished. Got some nice antique pine gloss varnish. And then quite soon I'm off on holiday to Lanzarote for a week. Now, I think it's there that people go and stand on the beach, because that's right in front of the airport. The runway starts at the sort of just after the beach, so I plan to go and stand there, get a video of 747s coming in, sort of at 25 feet or something like that for you. So that should be quite good fun. Now, some of you remember I started a restoration of another Metropolitan Vickers dynamo, a 50 amp one, a bigger, older thing. I found a contact of someone who can get me brushes for one, carbon brushes. So I think the next project will be to get that done and working, and then hopefully I don't quite know which one I'll pair with the Wolseley, but it might be that one. And I think it's more likely to be that one, because it's not so old. It'll look better with the Wolseley, and then I can keep the really old one to go with the Amanco. I think that would look nicer. But the Wolseley will get a new trolley, and hopefully be built as a generating set, because these handles come right out there. Wasted space. I can make the trolley longer, put a dynamo on there, and you know, I'm no worse off. Yeah, it'd be heavy, but hopefully in a couple of months' time I'll have a car and trailer, so that'll have sorted that out. Got some old oil tins. Very nice, those things, but I think you've seen those. Oh yeah, cream separator. If anyone's got any information on one of those, I'd be really grateful. It's an Alfa Laval Junior number 2, it seems. And they, as far as I can work out, they're quite scarce. You only seem to see the bigger Alfa Laval cream separators. I can't find pictures of another one of these. The plan with that, once the dynamo's done, obviously, is to put that on a wooden stand, so a stand a bit like a corn mill would go on. You might know sort of thing. And then that will have a reduction gearbox and hopefully run off the Amanco. That will be restored in the Manco Carnation Red as well, which I think will look quite nice. Not original, but I like the idea of that. What else can I tell you? Not a lot really. I put some strip lights in here, or a single strip light. Work with throwing. They've got about 20 of these they're chucking out, so I brought one home on the bus. Got some funny looks, but I'm sort of past caring really. but yeah, worked a treat, and it was free, so can't complain. Yeah, that's kind of it really. Oh yeah, another thing I got, power drill, Black & Decker power drill. That's a battery drill. The other one I've got is a very old steel case thing. That's a great drill, that one. If you're going to buy an old power drill, get one of them. They're brilliant. Nice chuck, proper chuck. You're never going to break that. And got a rev counter there as well. Oh, and also decided for the Manco, it's going to get a new fuel tank. First of all, have a listen. Full of sediment. Well, that doesn't worry me. But if you look at that filler neck, is held on with filler. Also, you'll notice that obviously it says Associated Manufacturers Company, gasoline, kerosene, water. There's an L there, it should say Waterloo, IO. That should say Iowa, obviously USA. So this is a bodge tank. This would originally have been, I think the top half would have been from a petrol Amanco. This is a petrol paraffin, because it's not a hit and miss. And it's been held together with filler in a number of places. Like, well, that's been resoldered, which I don't particularly like, but that one's been held on with filler, which is terrible. Also, I think it would be a nightmare to get all that paint off without it getting pinholes. So, I'm going to get a new one, regardless of the cost. I've got to. I want the engine to be right. So I should be skint for a bit, but okay. I'm used to that. Also need fuel lines and check valves for it, so I'll contact Frank Gelder for that. And also, just for your information, a chap called Kerwin Harris, he can do igniter pick springs for Amancos. I've also got to get one of those. Anyway, that's enough of my ramblings. So, I hope you've enjoyed the video. If you haven't seen it already, do have a look at my Bamford generating electricity video. Had it running in the dark, and it really came up quite nicely like that. Anyway, I hope you've enjoyed the video, and I'll get you another Amanco update as soon as I can. Thanks for watching.